Hello there, guys. Today I want to talk about a special product that came out last year. It's a pretty tiny thing, but does a lot of interesting stuff. This is the KISS Keychain Configurator by Alexander Fedorov. I hope I pronounce his name right, but most definitely you know him by Fedor Commander. He's a good friend of mine and he's the one responsible for the adaptive filter in the KISS Fly Controller. He's a passionate guy who loves to fly FPV and also code things. This PCB and software is designed entirely by him. This little tool here has a lot of capabilities to change almost every settings on your KISS Fly Controller. And why I'm saying almost every setting, because you cannot activate the Fly Controller because this is not a computer to have internet on it. And I heard that you could also configure Betaflight in the future if you take a Bluetooth module and connect it to the KISS keychain configurator. But I don't know too much about that. What I know is that it will work flawlessly with the KISS Fly Controller, with all KISS Fly Controllers. So yeah, besides all the Fly Controller related stuff, this thing could also charge your phone or every other device on USB, which requires 5 volts, of course. How this little configurator works, you feed in voltage from a LiPo or a power supply, 2 to 5S. I heard that it could take 6S, but it's not recommended. Most definitely Alex decided to make it capable of 6S, but he just recommends it to not push further than 5S, just to be on the safe side. I looked on the board, and if you look here, we have a switching regulator, which is the same switching regulator used on the KISS Fly Controller and a lot of other Fly Controllers. That takes 6S without an issue. So yeah, don't kill me if something happens. I will definitely say it's capable of 6S, but well, it's your decision. So let's power it up without a Fly Controller first and see what's happening here. Okay, so we have the first menu that we can see, and we have the FC setup, but of course now we don't have a Fly Controller setup. We have here tool setup. To go back, just press left for more than 1 second, and it goes back to the main menu. And here we have the tool info, which tells you the firmware version. Max configuration, I think it can save more configurations for Fly Controllers, I'm not betting on that. Voltage reads the voltage from the LiPo input. Right now I'm powering it from a power supply from 12 volts. And if I'm changing the voltage to 13, maybe my power supply is not accurate or this has some variations, but it's working. And it also tells you the cells. And if I'm going to, as you can see, it works on 6S without issues. So yeah. So, to be able to hook up any Fly Controller to the KISS keychain configurator, you have to get your hands on a OTG adapter. Looks like this. At least mine looks like this. It's a cable, micro USB to normal USB. There are some smaller ones that are like this, very short and tiny, but this is what I have on hand right now. Now I will take a normal USB, plug it in the OTG adapter, and right now I will plug this in the charger. And as you can see, the tool charges up the lipos, and now we also see USB charger menu. And if we go there, we have a lipo voltage and a cutoff. Say you want to charge up your phone and you plug in a lipo, a 3S lipo for example, and you just don't want to kill the battery, you have this cutoff feature, which is very helpful. Go back. And now let's plug in a KISS flight controller, a V2. And now try and go to the FC setup. So we have PIDs. By the way, these are not my PIDs, because this is a repaired FC. We have rates, TPA, filters, VTX, alarms, receiver. So basically all the things you could change on a KISS flight controller. We also have the ESC setup, but I don't have a lipo and no ESCs, of course. Model info. So here we have all the basic information from the flight controller, RX and motors. Here we have all the channels from the receiver and also the four motors. We also have motor test, but we don't have a lipo. The conclusion is that this is a pretty neat little tool that you must have on your backpack. It's a time saver and you can make a lot of things with it. From changing settings to your flight controller, ESCs, and also the charging function of this little tool makes it a must-have in your backpack. I definitely recommend this. You can find it on multiple websites, including the Flyduino website. And at the end, I want to give a big thanks to Alexander Fedorov, aka Fedor Commander, for all his hard work put into this hobby for all of us. And I bow my head. For all of you guys, thank you very much for watching and see you next time.